Hello everyone, this is the Lenneberg's critical period hypothesis on language or second language acquisition under the MTB-MLE. So today I will discuss to you further what is what's the concept of Lenneberg's critical period and what is the implication into teaching our young ones, especially from age 2 until puberty. That is the average age is age 2 until 12 years old. Okay, let's go. So who is Lenneberg? Eric Heinz Lenneberg was a linguist and neurologist, a little bit background of the proponent, who pioneered ideas on language acquisition and cognitive psychology, particularly in terms of concept and innateness. So, and he was born in Düsseldorf, Germany. So what is critical period hypothesis? This is the period where in the first few years of life is the crucial time in which an individual, student, or a child can acquire the first language if presented with the adequate stimuli. So in here, this is the crucial part because this is when the child or child learns his first language. So the first exposure now is the crucial part. Kung unsa ang iyang unang nga lingwahe mo to iyang sundon. No? So Lenneberg argued that language acquisition needed to take place between age 2 and puberty. So mo na yung gi-argue nga age, age 2 and puberty. So the average age for girls to begin puberty is 11, while for boys average is 12. So mauning age ato ang bantayan as teachers to wear in our instructional materials, our learning materials, our teaching styles may suit to their needs. Kana bang unsa nga klase nga instructional materials ang ato ang i-implement inside the classroom where we have this kind of age from 2 to, so for example, 2 to 12, or kung nag-eskwela na ba to, nag-eskwela na ba na, or as a parent, no, in a broader perspective, because that begins in our family, to age of 2, because sa education system na to, brag na sa 6 years old na to mag-start, or correct me if I'm wrong, inana. Pero but in preparation, according to this theory, sa age of 2 palang daan, bantayan na nato, no, take closer into the attitude, no, sa child, because it is again crucial part. Okay, this is the starting point of learning the language. I have a friend na siya ay kaning anak dayon wala siya gitudluan ba, wala siya gitudluan o language, wala siya gitudluan English language, but then tingalas lang ano naka-learn. Sa background di ay sa bata is nagatanaw siya ng salida nga anong kuan sa wala pipa ba na nasa Cartoon Networks ba na siya, oh, nag-English na siya dito at tapos matingalan sila nga ano nag-English ang bata, no, and then sa conversation sa bata is matingalan sila nga ano di man magbisaya, maipit siya, mayingon siya, I'm stuck, oh, liman ka na, oh. Then mingon siya, identify siya ang mga letters from A to Z. Kabalo na siya mag-identify. Nung una nakita niya sa part of his environment, itong television muna yung nakita dito. Pero siya itudluan, ano. Edad na itong bata is 2 years old. No? Again, that's the crucial part. That's why I came into an affirmation of this theory nga tinuod siya ay because that is the crucial part again of that age nga maka-learn ang bata. Mayroon kag letter C, mayroon siya o mayroon siya car, tag D, kung kita pa yung sa D, may tag dog na yun, pero yeah, like dump truck, ulit, no, dump truck. Yun na po si accent siya, na si accent nga mo ito yan, nadunggan sa TV or na yung nakita dito ah. So ingon ana ka a great imitator sa mga bata. That's why we need to be extra careful in attending to them because mo na ilang masunod. So according to Lenneberg, in humans, vocal learning seems to occur most readily within the age span defined as the critical period, katong ages bracket, no? In which hormonal, experiential, and age factors come into play. That is why when we teach, we really start with the sounds, no? When we teach the alphabet, we really need to teach them first the sound. That's the sound of A, B, C, and D. Pero sa ito, nandun is traditional way of learning. Pakantahan naman tayo A, B, C, D, F, G. Oh, ina na itong ma-learn. No? Sa memorization, actually, sa habituation na siya. Oh, mahabit mo itong ikanta. Tapos na siya ipikto mo ito yung ipang-explain. Na maka-learn ta memorization. Rutinary yung learning activity. In here, the theory gives importance to vocal learning na giingon is vocal meaning which start from the pronunciation. Learning activities for critical period. This is only a suggested activities for this crucial age. By age 2, kids start recognizing some letters and can sing and say aloud the ABC sound. One is yan. So 3, kids may recognize about half letters in the alphabet and start to connect letters to their sound. Aliga? Sound, the vocal man siya. Like S, sound the S, sun, suns. Okay. 4, kids often know all the letters of the alphabet and their correct order. Katong ganun lang, ito extraordinary itong bata kong example sa inyo because he learned the ABC age of 2 years old pa, nag-learn na siya ng yan, advanced kaya siya. No? By age 5, most children can use their hands and fingers, fine motor skills, but see to it, these skills are ready, the fine motor skills are ready. To hold pen or pencil colors, yan. Copy triangles and other geometric shapes. Triangle, square, pwede punta ka itong mga blocks, building blocks, suggested po na siya ng mga activities to help them build their fine motor skills. 5, decode basic words with strategies and identify sight words in order to read age-appropriate books. No? It's suggested, pwede punta mga children's book, no? Write simple words and sentences using punctuation and capitalization, no? This age. Ito na siyang, pwede na lang siya tudluan ni nani ang bata. No? Then, from 6 to 12, word games, expand your children's vocabulary and with word games. Jokes, but situate these jokes are relevant, no? Captivating that humor and creativity. Riddles, rhyme, homonyms, storytelling, songs, tongue twister. Okay, it may include teaching of grammar, no? Grammar. Because, again, in the field of grammar, daghan man to syntax, katong sa mga phonemes dito, todo siya matudlo, mga sounds again, pragma, conversation, pragmatics, pwede na nato siya matudlo atong mga fields na ito ang na-discuss. Then, what is the implication, no, of why we have to learn all these things? Now, the implication is that a teacher or the teacher must adjust his or her teaching learning materials relative to the age of the student or pupil or child. Now, atong i-adjust ang ato ang mga materials sa pagkat-on dito sa bata. Because again, we have to consider that his or her a child's readiness. The age of 2, there are suggested activities until 12. No? So, ingon niya na ang dagan sa pagtudlo sa mga bata. If it is the language acquisition, in terms of language acquisition. And again, we have to consider the native language of a child before teaching them the second language. If he has this first language in Bisaya, and nag-attend siya sa imong eskwelahan, sulod siya sa school nimo, so imo siya dapat na i-adjust ang imong learning learning materials para makatulog siya sa second language. So in ana, so English ana. Okay, so I think that is just for today in discussing these things of Lenneberg's theory. Later on, we shall learn another things, another theories regarding language acquisition, like that of Grashen. Okay, so thank you. Don't forget to subscribe for our future discussions for another related videos of this lesson. Thank you and mabuhay Mindanao.